Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with all the four editorials dated 23rd of May. Now most of the editorials in today's newspaper, they actually relate to international relations, IR. Now this IR portion, it's a part of General Studies Mains Examination Paper 2. Now in today's editorial page, we will be discussing three important international relations. First of all, we will be discussing about the recent visit of Donald Trump to Iran. Now this, to Saudi Arabia. Now this is very, very important. Secondly, we will be discussing about the important editorial about Myanmar. Now this is about how the polity is evolving in Myanmar. Myanmar mein political situation kaise emerge ho rahi hai, kaise federalism ki voices Myanmar mein strong ho rahi hai, aur kaise Myanmar in voices ko represent kar raha hai. And thirdly, we will be understanding in this editorial class the importance of Hassan Rouhani as the president of Iran. Now first of all, let us start with the Donald Trump to Saudi Arabia. Now kya importance hai diplomacy mein Donald Trump ke visit ka Saudi Arabia mein? Now in order to understand this importance and the relevancy from the diplomatic point of view, we need to understand that entire Muslim world is divided into two subcategories. Now the first subcategory is the category of the Shia countries, and the second subcategory is the category of the Sunni countries. So broadly what we have is the Shia countries and the Sunni countries. Now as far as the Shia world is concerned, now there are countries like Iran, Lebanon and Syria belonging to this category. So when it comes to the US diplomacy, US is generally against the Shia countries, and it has got more against the Shia countries after the 1979 revolution, that is generally known as Iranian revolution. Now what is meant by the Iranian revolution? The Iranian revolution took place in 1979. Before that, Iran was ruled by the Pahlavi dynasty. Now this Pahlavi dynasty jo thi, ye USA ke kafi zyada close thi. Now jab ye naya revolution aa gaya 1979 mein, is revolution ne Iran ko western influences se close kar liya. And the more importance was accorded to the Quran, the more importance was accorded to the Muslim world. So in 1979, more importance was given to the Quran in Iran, and lot of importance was accorded to the Islamic life. So Iranian revolution altered the entire culture, the entire polity of Iran with respect to the world. Now Iran, which used to be a very close friend of United States of America, it actually began an adversary, a very, very dangerous adversary indeed. Now the election of Hassan Rouhani, ab Hassan Rouhani ka election ho gaya hai. Hassan Rouhani was actually fighting against Mr. Raisi. Now Raisi, he represent what? Raisi represented the fundamentalist forces. The fundamentalist forces. Now Raisi was against the Western culture. It was against the nuclear deal that has been signed between Iran and United States of America. Abhi dekhiye, 30-40 saal Iran aur US kafi zyada ladte rahe hain, but under the presidency of Hassan Rouhani and Barack Obama, दोनों ने एक बहुत अच्छा न्यूक्लियर डील साइन कर लिया था. उस न्यूक्लियर डील की वजह से रेप्रोचमेंट काफी ज्यादा हो गया यूएस और ईरान के बीच में. तो जो रिलेशनशिप में काफी ज्यादा estrangement था वो खत्म हो गया. So the relationship became quite friendly, and because of this rapprochement, Saudi Arabia was not satisfied with the new policy, new approach of United States of America. Because USA हमेशा सुन्नी वर्ल्ड को सपोर्ट करता आया है, एंड सऊदी अरेबिया इस चीज से लेके खुश नहीं था. एंड जब डोनाल्ड ट्रंप का इलेक्शन हुआ, डोनाल्ड ट्रंप ने 7 देशों की जो मुस्लिम इमिग्रेंट्स थे उनको बैन कर दिया यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका में आने से. सो दिस क्रिएटेड अ काइंड ऑफ अ फर्दर एट्रिशन बिटवीन द रिलेशनशिप ऑफ यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका एंड साउथ अमेरिका. बट ऑफ लेट एक बहुत बड़ा चेंज आया है इस चीज में. तो वो चेंज क्या है? Recently, Donald Trump has visited Saudi Arabia, और $110 billion का defense deal sign हुआ है. So this is a kind of a very very big and realistic and substantive and strategic and diplomatic change from the perspective of United States of America towards Saudi Arabia and towards Iran. Now Iran, it is undergoing a lot of churning phase, whereby we don't know what is going to unfold between the relationship of USA and Iran. अब Iran और US का relationship क्या unfold करेगा ये हमें पता नहीं है, क्योंकि recently जो USA और Saudi Arabia का relationship है ये भी friendly होना शुरू हो जाएगा. So this will again create a kind of fundamentalism between Shia and Sunni world. एक पोलराइजेशन एस्टैब्लिश कर देगा. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सी दिस वर्ड इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. यू मस्ट बी यूजिंग दिस वर्ड इन योर मेंस एग्जामिनेशन, पोलराइजेशन. सो द पोलराइजेशन विल एक्चुअली बी गेटिंग लॉट स्ट्रेंथेंड, पोलराइजेशन बिटवीन द शिया वर्ल्ड एंड द सुन्नी वर्ल्ड. नाउ द सेकेंड एडिटोरियल, सी आई हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड बोथ दीज एडिटोरियल्स, आई हैव डिस्कस्ड द एंटायर थीम अबाउट हाउ द मुस्लिम वर्ल्ड इज डिवाइडेड amongst the Shia and the Sunni people, and how the Iranian revolution altered the relationship, and how the new relationship is emerging between USA and Saudi Arabia, and how it is altering the diplomatic tectonics between Iran, Saudi Arabia and United States of America. Now we'll be learning about something about Myanmar. Now Myanmar got its independence. Now the first of all we need to understand the demography of Myanmar. Now in Myanmar you have people, you have communities, disparate and diversified communities. Now this is important, diversified communities. Now what is meant by diversified communities? Diversified communities means we have different communities belonging to different ethnicities. We have communities belonging to the Muslims. We have communities belonging to the Buddhists. We have communities belonging to the Jain community. We have communities belonging to the Jews. So many communities are living in Myanmar. Now, before Myanmar got its independence, there was always a demand that in order to justice to these diversified communities, federalism must be established in Myanmar. But jab Myanmar ko independence milne ke baad, wahan pe military rule karna shuru kar diya. एंड मिलिटरी का जो सिस्टम ऑफ रूल था वो काफी ज्यादा अथॉरिटेरियन था, एंड मिलिटरी नेवर अलाउड दिस फेडरल फोर्सेस टू गेट स्ट्रेंथन. लोग डिमांड करते थे कि हमारा एक अलग ऑटोनॉमी वाला फेडरल यूनिट होना चाहिए अंडर अ वीक सेंट्रल कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. सेंटर पे वीक कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन हो और जितनी भी स्टेट्स हैं जिनमें अलग अलग कम्युनिटीज रहेंगी उनको ज्यादा इंडिपेंडेंस मिलना चाहिए. तो वो कभी भी अलाउ नहीं हुआ. तो जो बेसिकली जो फेडरलिज्म है इसकी वॉइसेस को हमेशा स्नब करती रही है मिलिट्री. बट ऑफ लेट अभी सेकेंड पीस कॉन्फ्रेंस होने जा रही है. एक पीस कॉन्फ्रेंस म्यांमार के इंडिपेंडेंस के टाइम पे हुई थी. नाउ द सेकेंड कॉन्फ्रेंस विल बी डिसाइडिंग अबाउट दिस इशू ऑफ फेडरलिज्म. नाउ दिस एडिटोरियल दैट आई एम डिस्कसिंग, इट हैज पुट forward certain concepts about federalism. It is discussed about symmetric federalism. Now what is meant by symmetric federalism? First of all, symmetric federalism basically means ki jitni bhi aapki sub units hai niche a b c d, suppose ye sari states hai, to sari states ko ek uniform tarah ki autonomy milegi. दिस इज सिमेट्रिक फेडरलिज्म. एक दूसरे तरह का फेडरलिज्म है हमारे पास, एसिमेट्रिक फेडरलिज्म. एसिमेट्रिक फेडरलिज्म क्या है, जैसे यूनिट्स हैं ए बी सी डी, ए एक अलग स्टेट है, बी एक अलग स्टेट है, सी एक अलग स्टेट है, डी एक अलग स्टेट है और इनके ऊपर सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट है. एसिमेट्रिक फेडरलिज्म के अंदर अलग अलग स्टेट्स को अलग अलग पावर दिए जाते हैं. एंड देन इट ऑल्सो डिस्कसेस अबाउट कोऑपरेटिव फेडरलिज्म. Then it also discusses about innovative federalism. Then there are numerous other types of federal concepts that it has discussed. Now why this editorial discussed so many concepts about federalism with respect to Myanmar? Because now Myanmar doesn't know itself what it will establish a federal system. Now take the case of India. In India we have a quasi-federal system in which the more power is confined, more power is with the central government. The state units, they have less power. So this was all about this editorial class. The fourth editorial relates to EBM. So I will be covering about these EBM in some other class. You can download our app. The name of our application is IAS Buzz. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.